Hey, my name is Peter. I'm a product manager here at Shapr, and I'm joined today by Jason Rodriguez over at 3D Connection, also a product manager over there. And we wanted to talk to you about our integration, so how Shapr integrated with 3D Connection's product line. This is one of the things we released in the past couple of months. We have had the integration on Mac OS for a while now, but we've just introduced the same functionality on Windows as well. And we believe this is a great productivity boost for professional users. So we want to take some time to walk through that, talk about the most important benefits, and actually show it to you in real life. So to kick us off, Jason, would you mind saying a few words about the 3D Connection's product lineup and their main benefits for ProCAD users?
Yeah, of course. Well, first of all, thank you for setting this up and having me join you today. It's really cool. And, you know, Shapr3D is one of those companies that we're really excited to work with because both of our mutual users are come from a non-traditional CAD usage background. They want to use a two-handed workflow, whether it be, you know, starting with a stylus and finger pinches on the iPad to moving on to the desktop and having that same control over the model and the navigation for design understanding. And so with the product line that we offer, we have a CAD mouse, which is a CAD slash CAM twist on a traditional mouse, with the difference that we have a dedicated middle click. And this is embraced by the CAD and MCAD community because this is used for primarily for panning. And then we also, on the side, we have the side button that gives access to the quick zoom feature, which unlike a traditional zoom, it allows you to zoom in, but also recalculates the rotation center point at the same time. So you always have a good understanding and control over the perspective. And the other devices that we have are a line of what we call the SpaceMouse, which is essentially a 6 degree of freedom sensor. So it gives you control over the X, Y, Z axis, and it allows full freedom of motion and navigation movement while allowing the two-handed workflow where you have the mouse, the standard mouse free for command interaction and things like that. So you don't have to involve it with navigation-based commands. And we have different types of space mouse. Like, for example, if we have mutual users that are on the go and they want to take their laptop and go to a coffee shop and start working there, you can take a SpaceMouse Pro Wireless, and that way you can, it's small, you put it, it comes with a little case, you could throw it in your bag, and it'll be a companion with your Shapr3D app that you can boot up on Windows or Mac OS or any other choice. And yeah, those are essentially, we have our flagship as well, which is the SpaceMouse Enterprise. And that device also comes with a full LCD screen, commands and icons, which Shapr3D has.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful. Look at that.
Beautiful device.
Yes. Comes with a standard. And we, your team worked with us, and you guys have a great standard command set. So Shapr3D users will be able to jump right in. And all of their heavily used commands have a really fast and quick access. And so it really gets you into a familiar environment right from the beginning.
Yeah. Let me just really quickly walk through you and our viewers about these features. So we've already mentioned the view navigation itself, that you can combine these movements. So this is what I'm doing now. I'm panning and moving and rotating the object at the same time. This is pretty basic, but even that by itself is super useful, because I can very quickly, for example, zoom in to this joint if I want to investigate that. And that is a very, very quick gesture. You mentioned the two-handed usage, and that can be super effective because I can do the view navigation with my left hand in that case, but I can use my other hand to use the pointer. And if I want to do things like, in this case, check the movement of this joint and check if there is enough space to move this joint or if I need to make adjustments. If I only had one pointing device, I could like adjust the object itself, but I could not change the view at the same time. But if I have another hand and I can do that at the same time, I could move my view and check that, okay, there's some freedom here, there's enough movement there, and I can keep on adjusting the object while I'm adjusting my view to have the best view for what I want to check. And that is a pretty powerful thing to do.
Yeah, and even when you're doing like any kind of command interaction, like for example, let's say you're drawing a line, like you're making a watch and you're drawing a line, and you want to use that line to create a revolve command and make the ring for the watch frame, you might want to be zoomed in really close to make sure your line is accurate and straight. But, you know, you might be zoomed in to a degree where, you know, you'd have to like move the model up. But with the Space Mouse, like you said, we can actually move the model like you're holding it in your hand.
Yeah.
And so when you're controlling the cap, it breaks that separation between screen and model because it feels like you're holding it. And so it's very intuitive.
We've been talking about multiple or 6 degrees of freedom. I think I've only exhausted 3 of those. So you have the option to lock in your degree of freedom, 1 degree of freedom, if you want to, if you're less experienced. And in that case, that is the whether we want to keep the horizon level or not. You could set this from the driver as well, but you can configure this within Shapr as well. And that is this rotation. Now, if you're an experienced user, this can be super useful because you might want to rotate your view to, say, for example, this bearing from the right angle. That could be useful if that is something that you're editing. But if you're less experienced, it could, like I am, you could make a mess and you could just sort of disorient yourself. So there's the option to take it, to turn it on and off. I would keep this option on for the time being just to make sure I'm not lost. There are 2 main navigation modes supported by SpaceMouse in Shapr3D. And most MCAD users tend to use the object navigation mode, which is, as you've said, works as if you were holding the object in your head and you're moving the cap on the SpaceMouse similar to how you'd move the object. So if I push the cap to the right, the object on the screen moves to the right, to the left, to the up and to the down. If I'm pushing it further away, the cap further away from me, the object goes further away and rotation works in a similar fashion. But some users, mostly people more familiar with architecture or CAD applications or designing graphical assets to be used in video, for example, might be more familiar with the camera navigation mode. And we fully support that in Shapr as well. In that case, you're adjusting the camera with the puck. So if I turn it to the right, then I'm turning my viewport camera to the right. If I push it in, I'm moving the camera closer to that. If I'm pulling the cap towards myself, I'm moving the camera further away, and so on and so forth. You could switch between these settings. Shapr remembers which one you chose. I'm more familiar with the object mode, so I'm going to switch back to that, but it's up to your preference. Yeah, you mentioned save views. Let me show you that real quick. So for example, I mentioned that you might want to zoom into this joint to check whether there's enough freedom or whether there's collisions. So you might want to store that. And in the SpaceMouse Enterprise, there are physical buttons for that. So I could just long press one of the buttons and you can see.
Or like here, check this out. Let's try this. So you see you're on that hole right there. It says 0 millimeters. What you could do, like, let's say, for example, you were designing this product and like that particular, the circumference of that was like 1 or 2 millimeters different than the other one. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to do a comparison. Yeah. You can, you know, zoom in real close, save that view. And then if you want to do a comparison.
Okay, let's do that. Let's make it a bit thicker. So it's like, let's make it 16 millimeter right there. And we could
get in close.
And I'm trying to adjust this one down here as well. And at this point, I forget what was the value. And I could just very quickly, because I saved that view, click that button again, and I'm back to that. And I could look at, okay, it's 16. Or actually, I
there
could,
you go.
Yeah. Even more, I could have saved this view as well. So
that's sorry, exactly what you should do. You have
I
two saved
views. Well. And I saved this view as well. And I could switch between the two real quick. So here I go, it's 16. Okay, let's make this one 16 as well. There you go.
Perfect.
And I could do that. And there are physical buttons to just go back to the big overview as well. we have buttons for the standard view, so front view, side view, rotating the views, looking at the top view. So we could go into the standard views real quick. When you're using a space mouse, when you're using a CAD mouse and have things set up the way you want them to be set up, and you switch over to Shapr, it's going to work the exact same way. If you prefer a certain navigation method, that will work the same way. If you have bound your soft keys in a certain way, you could do the very same thing for Shapr as well. All of the functionality of Shapr is exposed to the driver, and you could create the same bindings that you have. And for the default buttons, like the default views, saving view navigation, recalling save views, all of this basic functionality, it works exactly the same as in the CAD application you learned 20 years ago.
That's right. And just a quick note about that is that you're right. They're not they're not macros. They're direct command access. So if there are users who have a certain workflow and they like their macros, they can keep them and they can still use these as direct command access. So yeah, good point.
Yep. So let's talk about commands. But let's try it with a just simple thing. I would want to make this top yoke a bit lighter because we got that request from our customer. So let's just zoom into that the top face. Usually it would be the space key that is assigned to that sketch to face action, but I can just use the key on the space mouse to access that. Want a circle. I could edit there. I could adjust the size. And here comes another small thing that works a bit better with Shapr due to our legacy and our expertise in working with within tablets. In most places, we are detecting this setting and we are popping up this on-screen numpad where you can directly enter a number with your numpad or with your mouse without having to remove your hand from your mouse, which is pretty effective. So I drew this circle and I will want to extrude it. So I'm just hitting the extrude command on the space mouse again, directly setting this, and I'm pulling this down, the magic of direct modeling. I could just do that immediately. And again, here I'm performing a command and I'm adjusting my view immediately while I'm doing the command because I want to make sure I'm cutting through the entire top yoke, but I do not want to cut into the rest of the assembly. So I can just figure out that, yes, that's probably the right amount to cut. And I could just hit enter on the space mouse to confirm the action. And then it is done.
And then another cool thing, too, is that, you know, you might maybe you either you stick with the standard command set, but you can also configure from there and save your profile. And that way everyone can have a customized command set and working off of the base that Shapr provides. And if they, for example, forget, what command was that? All you have to do is hold down any button any programmable button on the Space Mouse Enterprise and a heads up display will pop up on the screen. All you have to do is hold down the button for a second or two. And there you go.
Yeah. And I could select from there.
You can see any command. So number 5. Okay, done.
Yep. And that is super useful. And yeah, you can customize all that. So when you open up the setting here, you could select the action. So for every soft key and basically every button on this device, you can select what you want to do. And as you can see, these are, as you've said, not macros. The functionality of Shapr is exposed to the driver as a result of our integration, and you could select these commands from here directly. So all sweep, subtract, split, and all the actions that are available in Shapr could be bound to these buttons to make sure it works the way you are used to working with CAD applications. We provide the same set of defaults, but you should by all means go ahead and customize it the way you prefer it to work. Well, thank you again for joining us today. Thank you for the introduction to the 3D Connection portfolio and all of these insights about the integration.
Pleasure.
It was a pleasure working with you guys. I mean, your technical team is top-notch and was a great help throughout this entire process. So
likewise, it's been a pleasure. And thank you again for inviting me as well. All right. Take care. It's been fun.